Good morning, students. Now we are going to learn introduction to microeconomics. This is first chapter in your 11th standard economics. Learning objectives of this chapter is to acquire a fundamental knowledge on the subject of economics and to understand its nature and scope, and to understand the meaning of some of the basic concepts of economics and to observe how they are applied in the various definitions formulated on the science of economics. I hope that you all understand about the subject economics from all the four sessions of the bridge courses. Introduction. A subject should have a name or a title that facilitates a clear and correct understanding of its contents. In a subject like economics, there are many books available with titles such as Introductory Economics, Economics and Introduction, Basic Economics, Elements of Economics, Elementary Economics, Fundamentals of Economics, etc. But these books have the same contents. Though each is intended to serve readers of a different levels of interest and capacity. A good introduction to a subject, besides containing the meaning of its title, should have an explanation of the nature and scope of the subject, that is, whether the subject is traditional or modern, static or dynamic. The readers should be in a position to clearly classify the subject as belonging to either arts alone or to science alone or to both. The significance of all the branches of the subject should find a place in it. As they go through the introduction, the reader should be able to understand the relationship of the subject with other subjects. Newer areas incorporated into the subject and the newer ways of comprehending its contents ought to be highlighted in the introduction. The methodologies applied in the derivation of its laws are to be stated in such an introduction. Next, we are going to learn the meaning of economics. The term or word economics comes from the ancient Greek oikonomikos. Oikos means household and nomos means management, custom or law. Thus, the term economics means management of households. The subject was earlier known as political economy. It is renamed as economics in the late 19th century by Alfred Marshall. What do you mean by economics will be in 2-mark question, mark it. And also, what is the another name for economics is political economy. This will be in 1-mark question, mark it. Economics, its nature. Next, we are going to understand the nature of economics. The nature of a subject refers to its contents and how and why they find a place in the subject. This nature is understood by studying the various definitions given by the notable economists. The existence of multiplicity of the definitions makes some scholars comment that a search for a clear definition of economics is an exercise in futility. J.M. Keynes, for example, observes that political economy is said to have strangled itself with definitions. Their presence makes studying the subject interesting, exciting, enjoyable, or worthwhile. In fact, their presence in a social science subject is clear a sign of the growth of the science. It indicates that there exists freedom for people associated with such a science to formulate fresh definitions. These associates appreciate and make use of the opportunity afforded to them and come up with a plethora of definitions saying plethora means large or excessive amount of something. Plethora of definitions saying the more the merrier. Each definition represents a unique generalization. A wide variety of definitions paves the way to arrive a near complete agreement on the subject matter of economics. As science grows stage by stage, and at every stage, its newer definition emerges and a concept associated with it receives some special emphasis. However, the study of subject is made possible when it possesses its clear-cut definition and boundary. In this paragraph, the meaning of futility means pointless or useless. Strangled means squeeze or constrict the neck of a person or animal especially so as to cause death. The four definitions. Each referring to particular stage of the growth of the subject of economics are presented here. They are Smith's welfare definition representing the classical era, Marshall's welfare definition representing the neoclassical era, Robin's scarcity definition representing the new age, and Samuelson's growth definition representing the modern age. This will be in one mark question. Sometimes in match the following, so please mark it. Wealth definition, Adam Smith. Adam Smith, in the years 1723 to 1790, in his book, An Inquiry into Nature and Causes of Wealth of Nations, 1776, defines economics as the science of wealth. He explains how a nation's wealth is created and increased. He considers that the individual in the society wants to promote his own gain, and in this process he is guided and led by an invisible hand. He states that every man is motivated by his self-interest. This means that each person works for his own good. Smith favors the introduction of division of labor to increase the quantum of output. Severe competition in factories and society helps in bettering the product. Supply force is very active and a commodity is made available to the consumer at the lowest price. The publication of Adam Smith, The Wealth of Nations, in 1776 has been described as the effective birth of economics as a separate discipline. This will be in one mark question. Mark it. Who wrote the book Wealth of Nation? The Adam Smith is regarded as the father of economics. Criticisms. For Smith, economics consists of wealth getting activities and wealth spending activities. An undue emphasis is given to material wealth. Wealth is treated to be an end in itself. This view leads him to ignore human welfare as an essential part of economics. Smith gives his definition: when religious and spiritual values are held high, Ruskin and Carlyle regarded economics as a dismal science, big science, etc. As it teaches selfishness, which is against ethics. This will be in 3-mark question or 5-mark question. Write a note on Adam Smith's definition or wealth definition. Mark it. Welfare definition, Alfred Marshall. The welfare definition is given by Alfred Marshall. Alfred Marshall, the year 1842 to 1924, in his book Principles of Economics, the year 1890. Please note down, this will be in 1 mark question. Defines economics thus, political economy or economics is a study of mankind in the ordinary business of life. It examines that part of individual and social actions which is most closely connected with the attainment and with the use of the material requisites of well-being. Thus, it is on one side a study of wealth, on the other side the more important side, a part of the study of man. The important feature of Marshall's definition are, economics does not treat wealth as the be-all and end-all of economic activities. Man promotes primarily welfare and not wealth. Second, the science of economics contains the concern of ordinary people who are moved by love and not merely guided or directed by the desire to get maximum monetary benefit. Economics is a social science. It studies people in the society who influence one another. Criticisms of a Marshall definition. Marshall regards only material things. He does not consider immaterial things such as the services of a doctor, a teacher and so on. They also promote people's welfare. Second criticism is, in the theory of wages, Marshall ignores the amount of money that goes as reward for the service of immaterial services. Marshall's definition is based on the concept of welfare, but it is not clearly defined. Welfare varies from person to person, country to country, and one period to another. Marshall clearly distinguishes between those things that are capable of promoting welfare of people and those things that are not. Things like liquor that are not capable of promoting welfare but command a price come under the purview of economics. However, welfare means happiness or comfortable living conditions of an individual or group of people. The welfare of an individual or nation is dependent not only on the stock of wealth possessed but also on political, social and cultural activities of the nation. Next, going to learn the scarcity definition. The scarcity definition is given by Lionel Robbins. Lionel Robbins published a book, an essay on the nature and significance of economic science. Please underline all the books and also author name. This will be in 1 mark question. According to him, economics is a science which studies human behavior as a relationship between ends and scarce means which have alternative uses. Here, ends means human needs and wants. The major feature of Robbins' definition are, ends refers to human wants. Human beings have unlimited number of wants. On the other hand, resources or means that go to satisfy the unlimited human wants are limited or scarce in supply. The scarcity of a commodity is to be considered only in relation to its demand. Further, the scarce means are capable of having alternative uses. Hence, an individual grades his wants and satisfies first his most urgent want. Thus, economics, according to Robbins, is a science of choice. Lionel Robbins considered economics as a science of choice because in our day-to-day life, we have to make various choices because we have scarce resources, but our wants are unlimited. Criticism. Robbins does not make any distinction between goods conducive to human welfare and goods that are not. In the production of rice and alcoholic drink, scarce resources are used. but the production of rice promotes human welfare, while that of alcoholic drinks does not. However, Robbins concludes that economics is neutral between ends. Economics deals not only with the microeconomic aspect of resource allocation and the determination of the price of a commodity, but also with the macroeconomics aspect, like how national income is generated. But Robbins reduces economics merely to theory of resource allocation. Next, Robbins' definition does not cover the theory of economic growth and development. Briefly explain, the scarcity definition will be in 3-mark or 5-mark question market. I hope that you all understand the meaning of economics, nature of economics, wealth definition, welfare definition, and scarcity definition. Thank you, students.